Good morning, sir. Good morning, students. This is Chalamar Reddy, sir. Now, today I am going to discuss that 3rd September 2020 mains second shift question with solutions. So already I uploaded two videos. This is third video. Now, still not yet subscribed my channel. Please subscribe the channel, like and share to your friends. Right. Now see the 12th question. If a by cos theta is equal to b by cos theta plus 2 pi by 3 is equal to c by cos theta plus 4 pi by 3, then find the angle between vectors, two vectors given, if theta is equal to 2 pi by 9 and a square plus b square plus c square is equal to 1 is. Now this is trigonometry and vectors, mixed conceptual question. Now first see that a by cos theta is equal to b by cos theta plus 2 pi by 3 is equal to c by cos theta plus 4 pi by 3 given. That value is equal to some constant. Now, that is, I am taking a is equal to, the constant should be, take any one of the value. So that is a lambda I am taking. A is equal to lambda cos theta. Then what is b? Lambda cos theta plus 2 pi by 3 and c is equal to lambda into cos theta plus 4 pi by 3. So in trigonometry we know that this is a standard result. A plus b plus c, that is equal to, take lambda common, three terms, add cos theta plus cos theta plus 2 pi by 3 plus cos theta plus 4 pi by 3. Now, sum of these three terms is equal to, in place of theta, whatever you can take, no problem. That value should be 0. So finally, we got a plus b plus c is equal to 0. Do that, squaring on both sides. What happened? Tell me. If you are done squaring on both sides, you will get a square plus b square plus c square plus 2 into ab plus bc plus ca, that is equal to 0. Here already given a square plus b square plus c square value is 1. Substitute here and send to right hand side. Finally, you will get AB plus BC plus CA value that is equal to minus 1. And here 2 is there now. That is also sent right hand side. Minus 1 by 2. So here we got one more condition. And find the angle between the vectors they are asking. So that angle I am taking cos alpha. Apply that. Angle between two vectors, we know that formula, cos alpha is equal to a dot b by mod a mod b. A dot b, it will come ab plus bc plus ca and divided by under root a square plus b square plus c square under root a square plus b square plus c square. So denominator, that is in the form of root x into root x. So we get x or not. Now finally, AB plus BC plus CA value is minus 1 by 2. And denominator we get A square plus B square plus C square. That's value already given. That is 1. Now overall we are getting minus 1 by 2. So cos alpha is equal to minus 1 by 2 means, what is the answer? That is cos 120 degrees. Okay, so cos alpha is equal to cos 120 degrees means, therefore alpha is equal to 120, or we can write another form, 2 pi by 3. Okay, this is a mixed conceptual question. Next I am going to another question. See this. Which of the following points, which of the following point lies on plane containing the lines? So here, but suppose this is on plane. Here two lines are there. One of the line is vector equation of the line passing through the point and parallel to another vector. So here one more line, the vector equation of the line passing through the point and parallel to another vector. Now here we need to find first equation of plane. Equation of plane means we need drs of the plane now. So this line is perpendicular to these two vectors. Okay, now that vectors I am taking, one is b bar. B bar is equal to I plus j plus k, and d bar is equal to minus I minus 2j plus k. So this is n bar. N bar is perpendicular to both b bar and d bar. So we need to find b cross d, that is we get n bar. N bar is equal to b bar cross d bar. How to do the cross product? We know that, that is I plus j, sorry, I j k. Now b bar coefficients 1 1 1 minus 1 minus 2 1. Now this is simplified. After simplification, what you will get? So here I am writing directly, that is 3i minus 2j minus k. For the time being, I didn't calculate it. Calculate yourself. N bar is equal to 3i minus 2j minus k. This is drs of plane only. Okay, so what are the drs here? 3 minus 2 minus 1, and the plane passing through two points A and C. Take any one of the point. I am taking that A point. A point, what is there here? Only I bar. That means 1 comma 0 comma 0. Now equation of plane passing through the point A 1 0 0 and having direction ratios. So this is a formula: 3 into x minus 1 minus 2 into y minus 0 minus 1 into z minus 0, that is equal to 0. This is the plane. Now simplify this: 3x minus 2y minus z minus 3, that is equal to 0. This is, we got a plane. But what they are asking, which of the following point lies on the plane? That means four options given. Substitute any one of the option. It is satisfied means that is lies on the plane. Now I am going to substitute second option. Second option, see that. What is there? 1 minus 3, 6. Substitute in this plane. We get 3 plus 6 minus 6 minus 3. That is equal to 0. 6 plus 3, 9. Minus 6 minus 3 minus 9. So we got 0. So finally, which point is satisfied? Second point. Now this is an easy question only. I'm going to next question. This is limits related problem. Observe the question. How to do that? First, substitute the limit. What you will get? I think you will get 0 by 0 form. If you got 0 by 0 form, what we have to do? Apply LH rule. What is LH rule? One time do the derivative numerator and denominator. Limit x tends to a. What is the derivative of first term? A square plus 2x square whole power 1 by 3. 1 by 3 into a square plus 2x square whole power 1 by 3 minus 1. That is minus 2 by 3. Internal derivative. A square derivative is 0. 2x square derivative is 4x minus. Here also do the derivative. 1 by 3 into 3x square whole power. We get 1 by 3 minus 1 mean that is minus 2 by 3. Internal derivative we get 6x all divided by same like that in denominator also. 1 by 3 into 3a square plus x square whole power minus 2 by 3. Internal derivative we get 2x minus 1 by 3 into 4x square whole power minus 2 by 3. Internal derivative 8x. Now observe here, some terms is going to cancel. First 1 by 3 is cancelled. Next x also cancel. Now substitute the limit. What happens? See, in place of x substitute a. Here 2a square plus a square 3a square and also 4 is a 4 into 3a square whole power minus 2 by 3 minus here 6 into 3a square whole power minus 2 by 3 and denominator also observe that we get we get 4a square whole power minus 2 by 3 and extra 2 also is there right here too minus 8 into 4a square whole power minus 2 by 3. Now observe the numerator. 4 minus 6 terms minus 2 terms. What are the terms? 3a square whole power minus 2 by 3. Same like that in the denominator. 2 minus 8 minus 6. What are the terms here? 4a square whole power minus 2 by 3. Now observe that minus 2 divided by minus 6. That means 1 by 3 or not. Next. So 3a square whole power 4a square whole power. The power is same. Now I am going to write 3a square divided by 4a square whole power minus 2 by 3. So a square is cancelled 1 by 3. But the power negative is there. So we want positive by observing the options. So do the calculation. So I am going to write reverse. That is 4 by 3. If we have written reverse, the power will get positive. This is the answer. This is also easy question. Next, I am going to another question. This is sequences and series related problem. See the question. I think different terms are there here. If the sum of first to n terms of the series is 488 and nth term is negative, then find Tn. Nth term we are getting negative. What is that nth term they are asking? But they didn't give n value. So we need to find n value. Now, first see that 20. Here 5 is not there. See each and every term having 5 now. Multiply and divide with 5 here. So we get 100 by 5 plus next term. That is 98 divided by 5 plus next 96 divided by 5. Next 94 divided by 5 and so on. That is equal to 488 given. That means sum of first n terms. Here n terms you can write. N terms. Okay. Now this is APR GP. See, 5 is common and numerator observe that 100, 98, 96, 94. The common difference is 2. Common difference is 2. Take 1 by 5 common. Right. Next. After that, A value is 100 and common difference is 2. 2 or minus 2. I think minus 2 is the common difference. Common difference is minus 2. Now apply the formula. What is sum of n terms? N by 2 into n by 2 into 2a, 2 into 100, 2a plus n minus 1 into d. What is d value here? Minus 2. That is equal to 488. Now do the calculation carefully. So what we get here, this is n by 10 into 200 minus 2n plus 2, that is equal to 488. Now after calculation this, we get n square minus 101 into n plus 2440, that is equal to 0. Now here split into factors, what we get? 101, so 6140. Multiply these two. What happened? 4, 4, 6 are 24. Yes. Now n square minus 61n minus 40n plus 2440. Here do the calculation. We get like this: n minus 40 into n minus 61, that is equal to 0. Then what are the n values? 40 and 61. If n is equal to 40, then what is the nth term? Tn. What is Tn formula? A plus n minus 1 into d. What is the a here? First term, 100, 100 by 5 plus a plus n minus 1 into d. N is 4. 4, 40 minus 1 into d. What is d here? Here we are taken common 5. That's why we got d is equal to minus 2. Now here common difference is minus 2 by 5 only. Now here take the LCM. What happens? See, 5 is the LCM. Here we get 100. 40 minus 1, 39. 39 2s are 2 9s are 18, 78. Here observe that 22 by 5, this is positive, but they are saying that negative. When it is possible, if n is equal to 61 means, I think it is possible. See, verify that n is equal to 61. Now Tn, that is equal to 100 divided by 5 plus 61 minus 1 into minus 2 by 5. Now what is LCM? 5. Here we get 100 and here we get minus 120. So minus 20 divided by 5, that is minus 4. We got negative or not? So if n is equal to 61, we got Tn is negative term. The Tn value is minus 4. See the options. Minus 4 is the correct answer. Next, go to the another problem. This is a differential equation related problem. Okay, observe that so many terms are there here. X cube dy plus xy dx is equal to 2y dx plus x square dy. First send dy terms one side, dx terms one side. Now right hand side dy terms send left hand side. We get x cube minus x square into dy, that is equal to, now xy dx send right hand side. After that, take y dx common. We get like this, 2 minus x into y dx. Now separate the variables. What happens? See, dy by y, that is equal to 2 minus x divided by, here take x square common, we get x square into x minus 1 dx. Okay, next what we have to do, apply the integration on both sides, dy divided by y, that is equal to integration 2 minus x divided by x square into x minus 1 dx. So left hand side term is easy only, but right hand side, see, we want to simplify. Split into partial fractions. How to split? This is a by x plus b by x square plus c by x minus 1. Now simplify this. After simplification, so we get the answers, a value is minus 1 and b value is minus 2, c value is 1. So for the time being, I'm writing directly because already I'm calculated. Okay, now try yourself, remaining calculation. See here, integration 1 by y dy, that is equal to, now after splitting this, what we get? Minus 1 by x minus 2 by x square minus 1 by x minus, sorry, plus 1 by x minus, and c value is 1 now, into dx. Now apply the integration. In left hand side we get log y. Now go to the right hand side. What we get? This is minus log x. Next, minus 2 into integration 1 by x square. What is integration minus 1 by x square? That is 1 by x only. Overall, here we get plus 2 by x, I think. Plus 2 by x plus integration 1 by x minus 1 dx, that is logarithm of x minus 1 plus c. Here already given y of 2 is equal to e. That means x is equal to 2, y is equal to e. Substitute these values here, we get c value. Substitute y value here, log e to the base e, that is 1, that is equal to minus log 2 plus 2 by 2, that is 1, plus log 2 minus 1, log 1, that is 0, plus c. Here 1 cancel, minus log 2, send left hand side. Finally, the c value is log 2. Now substitute there, and again they are asking y of 4, that means x value 4 substitute, then we get y automatically. Therefore here log y, that is equal to minus log x plus 2 by x plus logarithm of x minus 1 plus c. C means log 2. Now here we need to find y of 4. That means in place of x, substitute 4. Now what happens? See, log of y, that is equal to minus log 4. Here 2 by 4 means 1 by 2 plus 4 minus 1, that is log 3 plus log 2. Okay, log y, that is equal to here log a plus log b minus log c. That means logarithm of a b by c, 3 into 2 divided by 4, plus here only 1 by 2 is there. That is, I am writing logarithm of e power 1 by 2 to the base c. Okay, log e to the base c value is 1 now. So here we get 2 2s are 4. Now by observing these two, how to write? Only right hand side I am writing log a plus log b, log a plus log b. We get log 3 into e power 1 by 2. Now both the sides logarithm is there. So therefore y value is 3 into e power 1 by 2. So this is, we can write y of 4 is equal to 3 into e power 1 by 2. I think this is answer. Verify the options. Okay, students, I think all of you understood now. Here a small correction, see, 3 by 2 is there. We didn't written 2 here. This is 2 here. In this case, 3 by 2. Here also 2. Here also 2. So final answer is 3 by 2 e power 1 by 2. So this is a lengthy problem, but in differential equation, every time they are giving like this only. Okay, students, all of you understood now? Still now not subscribed my channel, please subscribe the channel, like and share to your friends. Okay, thank you.